Chapter 5, Difficult Days. One night in October, Jenny and I were in bed. Suddenly, I heard a crying of a girl. It came from the street. I felt afraid. I jumped out of bed. "Come with me, Molly," I said. "Please, John, don't go out there," said Jenny. "Call the police. I'll be careful," held Molly by the end of his chain. The girl cried again. We went outside. A man ran down the street. The young man ran to me. "Go and stay with the girl. Help her. Don't go after a man." I ran to the girl. It was my neighbor daughter, Lisa. She was 17 years old. Her shirt was red and wet. "What happened?" "I was in my car. A man got in and put his head over my mouth. Now," he said, "don't make noise." "I did it. He caught me with a knife." I held Lisa in my arms. "It's gonna be okay." Some minutes later, the police arrived with doctors and they took Lisa away. The policeman asked me questions. Then I got home with Molly. Molly is a different dog tonight. Nothing can hurt us if he loves us. I looked at Molly. "You did well tonight. Lisa didn't die and she got well again, but I never forgot that night." One night, Jenny said, "I think the baby's coming. Please call the doctor. Something's wrong," I thought. "It's too early for the baby." I took Jenny to the hospital. "Your baby is too small. We have to stop him coming out, so you will have to stay in the hospital." Jenny stayed in the hospital for 12 days. I stayed at home with Molly and Patrick. Molly and Patrick, I did housework and everything at home.